God with us, what a thought. The architect, ruler, and sustainer of all creation. Choosing to come to earth with the heartbeat of a baby.
One night in a stable in Bethlehem's town, a king of all kings from heaven came down. He was born of a virgin, as the prophets foretold. He came to this earth from a city of gold.
The King chose to leave His throne to come to earth, choosing to become one of us. The story of Christmas is a story about choices. We're going to discover that every person who took part in the wondrous event we call Christmas was faced with choices, beginning with God. For God Himself chose the perfect moment in time and the precise location for the birth of the Savior. He chose a common teenage girl to be the mother of His Son. I wonder how many of us have ever pondered or considered the dilemma of this young Jewish girl named Mary, the one God had chosen. She was engaged and waiting for her wedding day when an angel appeared to announce that God had selected her to bear his son. Although God had chosen Mary, would she submit to the will of her Lord? You see, God would never force Mary to do something contrary to her will, for God gave mankind from the beginning of time the freedom of choice. Would she choose to obey God or would she run away? Would she tell Joseph, her fiancé, of her glorious blessing, or would she hide in shame? What would her parents think? What would her friends think? Surely she realized the consequences, yet she still chose to surrender to the Lord's marvelous plan for her life. "Be it unto me according to your word," was Mary's choice.
The road ahead will not be easy. The task before me seems so great. Lord, I don't know why you would choose me, but I will trust you and obey. I will be your servant, body, mind, and soul.
The Lord does all things well, and what he does perfectly and completely. Just as God chose Mary, he had also chosen Joseph to be the earthly father to his heavenly son. Now Joseph was a just man, and after hearing of the coming child, not wanting to disgrace Mary, he decided to secretly break the engagement. But God intervened and sent the angel of the Lord to Joseph in a dream and told him the child that Mary was carrying was conceived in her by the Holy Spirit. Joseph pushed back his fear and chose to obey the voice of God and took Mary to be his wife.
My trembling heart has many questions. Lord, I don't really understand, but you assure me of your presence, and I surrender to your plan.
I will be your servant, body, mind, and soul.
And Mary brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes. And suddenly a multitude of the heavenly host began praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
And goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announced his arrival in the little town of Bethlehem. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy. He was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God in the highest glory. Hallelujah to the Lord, amen. Glory to God in the highest. On earth and goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announced his arrival in the little town of Bethlehem.
shepherds, simple men with humble hearts, were filled with fear when the angel of the Lord and the glory of His presence lit up the sky that first Christmas. The angel revealed to them that a Savior had been born. Leaving their flock and their responsibility, the shepherds hurriedly traveled to Bethlehem to find the baby who was Christ the Lord. And there He was, lying in a manger, just as the angel had said. Scripture revealed that they could not contain what they saw and what they heard. It's amazing that common keepers of sheep were the first to be invited to see the Savior of the world. Think what the shepherds would have missed had they chosen to disregard God's invitation. We are not certain of the exact time, but we do know that men of great wisdom from a distant country saw a brilliant star. Leaving houses and lands, they chose to follow that majestic star wherever it would lead, no matter how long the journey might take. What would cause these men to follow a star? Why would they spend a portion of their life and their own money looking for the king of another kingdom? These honorable men searched diligently, bearing gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. They were determined to find the king, the young king, and to worship him. Sometimes we fail to consider the human side of the story. The star that led the wise men brought them first to the city of Jerusalem. It's not surprising that these learned men went through official channels in their search for the Messiah. They questioned Herod, the governor of Judea, as to the whereabouts of this new king. He had to consult a chief priest and scribes to learn that the ancient scrolls had prophesied Bethlehem, a small village just 5 miles from Jerusalem, as the place where Christ, the Messiah, would be born. I can imagine as these men entered this town of prophecy, they probably stopped someone and inquired where the king might be found. Yet those who lived within the very town did not know the Son of God was in their midst.
You say you travel far, bearing treasure. You say these gifts are for the new king's pleasure. I've heard that a king might come, but until now there hasn't been one.
Get in time, and I think he's just a few doors down the road. There's a new kid in town, but he's just another baby, I suppose.
gently, soft as a baby, born to a lowly virgin girl.
The love that came gently that night in Bethlehem changed the world forever. The one who was prophesied by the ancients, proclaimed by the angels, praised by the shepherds, and pursued by wise men. He is Savior, Redeemer, Lord, and King. The angel told Mary to call his name Jesus.
Jesus, Savior.
Thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
Jesus.
He shall be great, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
Jesus.
He shall be called Wonderful,
Jesus.
Counselor, the Mighty God,
Jesus.
The Prince of Peace.
Jesus, call him Jesus, 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 Jesus. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn
days all around the world, people will celebrate this holiday season in some form or fashion. Many of them not really understanding why this time of year is so alive, so anticipated, why it touches our emotions. What is Christmas? What is at the heart of it all? Let me ask you, what's the most memorable Christmas that comes to your mind? As a child, what was the best gift you ever received? Was it a certain baby doll? Or maybe a brand new bicycle or a wagon? Some toy or favorite game? For you adults, was it something sparkly that went on your finger? Maybe it was in the driveway with a big bow on the windshield. There are some of you older folks that remember when families weren't as financially blessed as they are today. It was a treat to get an apple, a couple of oranges, maybe some walnuts or pecans. Others of you would say the best Christmas you can ever remember was when family was all together in the same house, under the same roof, and life was simple. How easy it is in the day we live to miss the heart of Christmas. All the collected memories, the celebrating, the feasting, our most precious and favorite gifts cannot compare to the gift that laid in a manger on Christmas morn. You see, the heart of Christmas is Jesus, God's gift, the gift that is beyond what you and I could ever comprehend. The greatest gift of all time, for it is the gift of eternal life. The heart of Christmas is the heart of God Himself. God reaching down from heaven to love, to redeem mankind. For God so loved the world that He gave His Son that we would not perish, but have everlasting life. God's greatest gift can be yours and it can be mine. Each of us must choose what we will do with the gift God extends to us.
Some say life is just a series of decisions. We make choices, we live and learn. Now I'm standing at a crossroad, and I must choose which way to turn. Is all the world can offer, all its power, its wealth and fame. Down the other, just a man with nail scars in his hands, but there is mercy in his eyes, and there is power in his name. I choose Jesus, I choose Jesus, without a solitary doubt. I choose Jesus, not for miracles, but for loving me, not just for Bethlehem, but for Calvary. Not for a day, but for eternity. I choose Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. Decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back.
I have decided to follow
for Calvary. Not for a day, but for eternity. I choose Jesus. I choose Jesus.
Many of us chose to follow Jesus years ago and have worshiped this King for many Christmases. Christmas calls us to remember that a Savior came to give His life. It calls us to remember Mary's complete surrender, Joseph's willing heart, the shepherd's blind faith, the wise men's determination to worship. Christmas calls to the followers of Jesus to remember our commitment and our need to give the Lord first place in our lives. And yes, Christmas calls us to remember the sweet and precious memories surrounding this time of year.
Family around the tree, children laughing merrily, unwrapping shiny toys and making so much noise. We've waited patiently all year, and now the day is finally here. But in the middle of it all, we stop as we recall that though we love this special feeling this day gives us, in our hearts we realize that it's not Christmas until we gather around that old piano, singing songs joy again. Oh, what a holy night, sharing smiles by candlelight. And then we read that old familiar story of how a Savior came from glory to bring us peace on earth through the wonder of Christmas till we remember. It's not the boxes and the balls, it's not playing in the snow or the family gathered dear. It's memories that we possess of so many Christmases, celebrating Christ the King. That's the most important thing. So once again, we ask you, of how a Savior Christmas till we
The heart of Christmas is Jesus, God's greatest gift. We are here to celebrate His birth, for we have made our choice to worship, honor, and serve this Savior who is Christ the Lord.
God in the highest, peace on earth and goodwill to men. Heavenly angels announce His arrival in the little town of Bethlehem. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy. He was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God of the highest glory. Hallelujah to the Lord, amen. Hallelujah to the Lord, sing holy. He was born to save the world from sin. Glory to God of the highest glory.
Calvary, not for us.